Yo, what's up, guys? Did you know that Steam pretty much has Discord built into it? Did you know? Their own version? Well, you're gonna find out today if you didn't. I'm gonna show you that in great detail. But first, if you're not subbed, please consider subbing to the channel and hitting that little bell icon to be notified about all our upcoming videos and giveaways and all that good stuff, because we will be posting a lot of them. So I hope you like this content, and you throw us a sub if you do. So, let's get started here. So this is Steam, right? You're going to see my group here, Oathbound Gaming group, right? And we have group chats down here. I'm going to show you from the beginning how to do this. And just a little story about how we found this. One of our guild members, who were playing a co-op game together, and he was online, but he got kicked out of Discord, and we also had a backup TeamSpeak server, got kicked out of that too. There was some sort of routing issue going on because he's in Australia, right? But Steam was working fine for him, so we said, you know what? Let's see if we can connect with voice. And then we started realizing how in-depth the Steam's voice feature and community is. Check this out. So you're going to want to pull up your friends list, right? At the bottom, you can see group chats. Create a group chat. Take a look at this. Chat name, Oathbound Test. All right? And I'm gonna invite Bucky. I'm going to invite Duck, Harley, Snatchy. Because I know they're online right now. I'm going to invite them. Ready? And it popped up over here. So, Oathbound Test. And you'll see the group members right here. This is pretty much a Discord server right here. Don't believe me? Check this out. Add voice channel. No one else is in this voice channel. We're going to save this voice channel after adding it. And we're going to save it in main voice one. So now, if I leave, that channel will stay there and they can join that. So we can join whenever we want. Now, I'm in that channel. And we can quick chat to anyone else. Messages will clear when voice channel is gone. So this is a quick chat just for people that are connected to that voice chat, right? But that's not all. We can always add a text channel. A general chat. We can add a general chat. Test. Hi. And there you go. It's in there. You can add your key bindings. I have mine set to V, my push to talk. There we go. Bucky responded. So you can set all your stuff here. Push to talk, push to mute, open microphone, change your input, output. You can do all this. The advanced settings, it has its echo cancellation built in, noise, automatic voice. This has Discord built in. It really does. Steam has their own Discord community built in, and it's quite impressive. That's not all it has. Like, you could simply click the little plus here if you want to add more members to the group, to the group chat. You can make your own link, expires never, an hour, whatever it may be. Copy a link and send an invite to this. And one of the things that I really like about this is it's a great backup. Like I said, we already had a chance to use this. It was great, you know. It really helped us out. But there are times when we need an extra voice server. If you don't believe me, take a look. I always have a Discord and a TeamSpeak running at the same time. And the reason for that is Discord does not have like whispers, like whisper targets. Like, you hold a different key and you talk to specific people rather than the entire Discord server. I lead a guild of a large amount of people in MMOs, and there's times when we have to talk with just the class leads or the officers in the middle of like a raid or a PvP event, whatever it may be. Be like, hey, you know, what do you guys think about this piece of loot? Where should it go? So we used it for like a loot council system in World of Warcraft, you know, classic WoW. And being able to have multiple voice servers is amazing. You can use this for that. You can have your Discord and this if you wanted, for whatever reason. I understand that's like a small amount of people would want to dual wield voice servers, but heck, that's there. And then let me show you a little bit more. At the top right, you could change your notifications. Hey, notify me for every message or direct message. The at thing works in this chat as well. At all, at online. So instead of everyone, it's at all. That'll take a little getting used to, right? But yeah, you can override settings for a channel. I was blown away by this. I didn't realize how advanced this was. And then when you click this little wheel up at the top here, you can change the icon, you can change Oathbound Test. with a gaming stuff be at? Now look, now it's got a little with the gaming stuff be at. So that's there. You can change the icon. That's the obviously the owner where they go, but you can change permissions here. You can add a role, officer, right? So now I have the officer role here, and you can edit the role and say, hey, what can they do? They can kick members, they can ban members, invite new. It's incredible. It's really, really amazing. And I'll say this, not to take a shot at Discord, you know, they provide a great service. They do that spy stuff, you know? They're obviously selling your information. I mean, it's no secret. I hope no one's going to debate me on that, because it's all over the interwebs. But this shouldn't. I'm not going to say Valve won't, but they shouldn't. I'll look into that more. Plus, this is technically a paid service. I'm pretty sure you need to have a paid game, a paid product on your account to use this. But honestly, this blows me away at how advanced this is. I did not realize there was a hidden Discord in Steam. I'm going to be honest, this is a full replacement. You really don't need Discord if you didn't want to use it and you wanted to just use this. But a large amount of the communities are on Discord. A lot of people like to use Discord. So you'd have a little bit of like a, I don't know, a fissure between your community. Be like, I don't want to use the Steam voice thing. You know, I get that. But it's here. If you want to do that, it's here. And if you did go to Steam and you joined the Oathbound Gaming group, you will find that we do have one up here. We have the group chats. We can add voice and stuff like that, which we'll do. We'll flesh this out now that I know this is here, now that I know that this is actually a thing that exists. Plus, we have a Discord channel as well. I mean, there's no reason not to have both. Plus, you can always ban people, and that's always fun. So create new text and voice channel. You can do that from here rather than on the left side. I guess this is a lot more simple. Test tickle. I think I'm clever. And you can move it up, move it down. But anyway, guys, I hope you guys liked this video. I hope you guys learned something here and realized how advanced this thing can be with Steam. So, thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this quick video. And if you have any questions about it or you want to test it out with me, go ahead and toss me an invite or let me know in the comments below. And if this is something you would use, let me know in the comments below. I'm curious if this helped any of you or if anyone's going to jump on this and be like, I'm making one now. Let me know. I want to hear. So thank you very much for watching. I will catch you guys in the next video. Skedaddle!